Guys, what's going on? My name is Lewis, and God bless every single one of you. Today is February 29, 2024, and welcome to the Grand Supreme News Channel. Alright guys, so we have some urgent information coming out. If you can, please share this video. And it says here, frankly, if Ukraine fails, I really think NATO will go toe-to-toe with Russia. Now, this is coming out from Lloyd Austin. Very important person here, sounding the alarm. We have more breaking news update. French President Emmanuel on Thursday said that all his comments on the war between Ukraine and Russia were carefully thought out after he sparked an uproar by not ruling out sending Western troops. You guys see what's going on here, right? They are announcing a new biblical war. And it's coming. It's coming. And at the same time, you have the leader of the bear, Russia. Vlad warns of nuclear war. Alright guys, before I start, give this video a big thumbs up. Share this video with your friends, families, and loved ones. I appreciate the love and support. And for those of you that want to contribute to the channel, once again, the PayPal link and the Patreon link is in the description box. Also guys, $1 a month Patreon. We get you access to our live stream every Sunday. We talk about things that we cannot talk about on the platform. Also, I posted videos today. Those links will be in the comments box. And for those of you that want to send us letters, prayer request, you can send it to me, Lewis Santiago, at 3432 US Highway 19, number 2, Holiday, Florida 34691. Guys, make sure you share the video. Very important information is coming out. These are very important people here that is sounding the alarm. This is the war drum, all right? The beat of the drums is sounding. The trumpets is blasting. I do believe that we're going to see something big is going to hit the fan pretty soon. Already, you have British soldiers in UKR. Alright, so we are seeing that great stuff is happening. And many, many people need to start preparing spiritually, physically, and mentally. I just posted this video not too long ago. The views is not great. Again, I don't know if people's not receiving my notification, but these videos are extremely important. This ain't no alien stuff. This is biblical stuff. So again, nation against nation are rising. These are the signs that our Lord and Savior has warned to be prepared and get ready, because things are gonna hit the fan. In order to prepare yourself, you have to prepare yourself spiritually by repenting, by believing in Christ, for He's the only way. I'm not going to tell people get a bunker. I'm not going to be telling that because, again, look, you have the right to prep. But the number one thing that people need to do is confess their sins and turn away from the things of the world. The problem is that not too many people is putting out these type of messages. A lot of people just promoting, like, all these, buy EMP, buy this food and this and that. Again, that's nice. That's beautiful. But the message, you cannot leave the gospel in the closet. You cannot leave it there to collect dust. What Jesus did, He brought that good news to everyone. That good news needs to be shared. The light need to be brighter in this dark world. Spiritually, the minds of hearts of many is really dark right now. Alright, so let's see what's going on here, guys. I did post a video not too long ago. If you guys want to check this video out, extremely important here. We have more information about space. Alright, so you have U.S. become biggest blank to space security. So the Red Dragon is sounding the alarm. The Red Dragon is saying that the sleeping giant is actively deploying offensive weapons in space and conducting military exercises, which makes it the biggest warning to space security. The sleeping giant has already become the biggest driving force in militarizing space and turning it into a battlefield. This link will be in the comments box. Like I say, guys, I'm posting very important stuff. I don't post alien stuff here. And I know alien stuff gets a lot of views, but that's not the real message. Alright, so focus on the real message. We are seeing the signs of the things of the world that's related to Bible prophecy. All right, so you have UKR defeat would raise risk of clash between the Bear NATO Sleeping Giant Defense Secretary said. Now, again, he's saying NATO. It's not the Sleeping Giant. Even though the Sleeping Giant U.S. is member of NATO, he's saying we're not going to get involved. But, again, guys, this is a game of chess. They are going to get involved. They're going to be sending a lot of ching ching to NATO members out there. Here you go. Here you go. Good job. You could go in. Poland. Wait. Hold on, Poland. Don't go in. Germany. Go. Go, Germany. You guys been really tough on us. You guys really been backing out. So, again, I do believe that it's going to be a few NATO members going to go to the yellow and blue country. They're not going to send a whole bunch of members. I do believe Article 5 will be activated, but it's not going to be the entire members going at it against the Bear. So I just don't see that happening. They're going to do it, they're going to split it. Lloyd claimed that the Bear leadership won't stop there if the yellow and blue is defeated. It says here, Washington, February 29th, if the yellow and blue falls or fails, the Bear and NATO could come into a direct conflict. All right, so guys, listen up. These are very important stuff here. These are the people that know what's going to happen, and again, they have a time frame for all this. They don't give us much detail. You can see this is all the information. They don't give us that much details. This is all the information, but we have some kind of idea that they know that big biblical war is going to hit the fan. So get your go bag ready, spiritually prepare, and just stay righteous in these tough times. Do not let the things of the world change your mind of, it's okay to accept the abomination. Don't accept the abomination. Don't accept the mark. Do not accept nothing of this world. Only accept Jesus as Lord and Savior. That's it. That's the only one we should be accepting. It's Jesus. That's it. Jesus. People's going to be like, what about, LeBron James? Nah, he ain't no king. Even though they call him King James, remember, Christ is king of all kings. Anybody call himself king, King David, King Nebuchadnezzar, King Cyrus, King this, King that. Again, there is a king of all kings, and his name is Jesus. If the yellow and blue fails, the Bear and NATO could come into a direct conflict. This is coming out from Defense Secretary Mr. Lloyd told the House Armed Services Committee. He said the Bear leadership won't stop there if the yellow and blue is defeated. Quite frankly, if the yellow and blue falls, I really believe, here we go, this is the one, NATO will be in a fight with the Bear. NATO will fight the Bear. Mr. Austin said in a hearing dedicated to his certain personal issue in January. All right, so that's very important. NATO will be in a fight with the Bear. Now we're going to go with this one here, because Emmanuel is the one that seems like he's going to lead it. He's going to lead this one. Mr. Z has failed. Even though we sent all that ching ching to him, it seemed like someone else is gonna come into the spotlight. There's gonna be another king. Again, scriptures mention kings as leaders. There's gonna be another king, and this one here possibly is going to try to go toe-to-toe with the Bear. It's either him or Polish president, but I believe he will be the next one in the front line. So once again, the next one in the front line, Emmanuel. And he says the yellow and blue troop deployment comment thought through. So it took him a while to think about this. So he did visit the Bear country in 2022. He shook hands with Vladimir and he spoke to him. And, he kind of spoke to him and said, hey, we don't need to go this far. Maybe we should talk things out. 2 years later, we're sending troops. something going on here. And again, like I say, guys, everything is all quiet. I mean, look at all this information. This is all we're going to get. They just keep everything quiet. But we see the signs. And we don't need to know about their plan because scripture tells us everything. That's the good news. And the good thing about it is we could all be saved from all this. How could we, you know, be saved, Lewis? Bunkers? Nah. Aliens? Nah. You know, the only way of being saved is by repenting, staying in prayer, and focusing in a righteous path, the path of Jesus Christ. That's the only way. That is the only way. Sadly, I believe that only a few will hear the message because so many are so focused in the things of the world. And this is why we put out all these very important videos, the things that's happening in the world that's related to scriptures and how people need to start breaking that chain spiritually and getting out the things of the world. Because the things of the world, those in the world are doing an amazing job by keeping many, many, many spiritual souls in this world. So, look, when the devil do his thing, he doesn't come with a pitchfork or a long tail, horn. The devil will come out like a regular person with a Bible in his hand. Do you know Jesus Christ? I want to sit down with you. Come on, let's. Yeah, you know Jesus? I know Jesus. Man, man, we go way back. So, again, we see all these false teachers and all these false pastors. They claim to know Jesus, but they're wolves disguised in clothing of lamb. Once again, we have another kingdom that's going to rise and go against the bear, the king of the north. You have the French leader Emmanuel on Thursday said that all his comments on the biblical war between the yellow and blue and the bear were carefully thought out. After he sparked an uproar by not ruling out sending NATO soldiers. Emmanuel on Monday said that everything that is necessary must be done to ensure the bear defeat after its invasion of the yellow and blue, alarming several European allies, including Germany. These are sufficiently serious issues. Everyone of the world that I say on this issue is weighed though through and measured, Emmanuel told reporters. So again, it took him a while, but it's not only him. I mean, it's all the members of NATO, NATO. They thought about this and they know the consequences. They know this thing is going to hit the fan. They know that, you know, the entire system will be impacted and price is going to hit the roof. So they're willing to take that chance. Now, here's my message to many, many people out there. Like I said, number one, spiritually, you need to get ready. You need to prepare spiritually with Christ. Number two, if you want to prep, go ahead and prep. Scriptures talk about people prepping, even in the time of, Egypt and all them, you know, again, you had the pestilence going on, all the people collecting wheat and food. There were great famines and pestilence, and people used to press. So you could prep. You could, you know, and I recommend that people help each other and pray for each other in these tough times, because scripture tells us at the very end, there will be all these biblical wars, but it's going to lead to more event. After more event, it's going to be a chain reaction. Prices, the sun eventually will be blocked. And the water will be bitter. It will be wormwood because of all the blasting and stuff. And a lot of these NUKE, they will impact these clouds. And when it rains, it's going to rain radiation. So, again, what should we do? Pray. Pray. When that time comes, pray. When the mark comes, pray. Again, Psalms chapter 93, 91, I think it is. God said he would take care of his people. Jesus took care of his people. He fed more than 5,000. So stay in prayer. I do believe when things hit the fan, again, we will see great miracles. We will see signs of the heavens. We will see God coming and saying, I will protect my people. So you have Emmanuel on Monday said that everything that is necessary must be done to ensure the bear defeat after its invasion of the yellow and blue, alarming several allies, including Germany. Now, once again, these are, I'm going to skip that part. So Emmanuel declined to comment further. That's it. That's all we're going to get. Everything else, not saying no more. My boss, Mr. Byrne, told me not to say no more. Emmanuel has said after a conference of European leaders that while there was no consensus on the sending of Western ground troops to the yellow and blue, nothing should be excluded. Most of Emmanuel's European allies said they would not send soldiers to the yellow and blue, while Emmanuel also insisted any such forces could be sent to back operations such as de-mining rather than fighting the bear forces. In an apparent response to Emmanuel, the bear leader said in a State of the Nation address Thursday that we also have very, very powerful equipment that can hit target on the territory and warn of a real risk of nukes. That's why Sleeping Giant said, we're not going to send troops. We're not going to send troops. Other lands like, we're not going to send them. We're not going to send them. Emmanuel's like, well, we thought about it. And we're still thinking about it. But why you have to bring nukes? See, we can't do this one-on-one. The bear's like one-on-one. It's me against NATO. So, yeah, now this video here, you guys really need to check it out because the bear leader warns NATO of nuclear biblical war. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. Again, check out the videos I posted today. For those of you that want to give a like to Christ, you can email me. My email is in the description box. Me and my wife are here to help many and to lead many to the righteous path. And that's the path of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. For those of you that want to send us letters or prayer requests, you can send it to me, Louis Santiago, or my wife, Jessica Santiago, at 3432 U.S. Highway 19, number 2, Holiday, Florida, 34691. Once again, guys, $1 a month Patreon. We get you access to our live stream every Sunday. We talk about things that we cannot talk about on the platform. Also, I posted videos today. Those links will be in the comments box. Thank you so much for watching. God bless you all. Put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ, for he's the only way, the truth, and the life. No one gets to the Father but through Jesus. Thank you so much for watching. Till next time, later. Peace.